Hello friend, I am Naval. You are watching Code with Naval. Welcome to Java series part 35. In our last video, we saw switch case statement. In this video, we are going to discuss about loop statement, or we can say iteration statement. For a looping, for iteration, Java provide a while loop, Java provide a do while loop, then for loop, then for each loop. So why we use a loop? Why we use a iteration? If you have a list of value and we want to print one by one, we want to get one by one value, then we simply put those list in a loop and we will get one by one value. Okay, let's first understand what is a while loop. A while loop is a control flow statement. It's executed repeatedly based on a given boolean condition. We use a while loop for a iterate statement. It execute again and again until it's not get false. If you have a condition value, then use while loop. Okay, if you have a condition value, then use while loop. Here simply, if a condition is a true, then control go in a statement and execute that statement, and again control come in a condition, again check the condition, again if condition get true, until this condition not get false, it's a repeatedly executing, it's a iterating repeatedly. Once this condition get false, then automatically control will come outside this iteration and execute after this statement line. Okay, let's open Eclipse and let's perform practical. I'll simply open Eclipse. Here I'll simply create one new class and I'll give this class name part 35. Okay, let's create here main method, simply main method, and I'll define here initial variable value int a equal to 1. Now I want to iterate, I want to print value 1 to 10. For that I'll simply use a while loop. Okay, while I'll simply provide this value, a value less than equal to 10. Okay, that means this a is less than equal to 10, that much time this while loop execute. Okay, I'll simply print here system.out.println and I'll type here while loop. And I'll simply here append this a. Now what you think, do we get 1 2 3 4 up to 10? No, we don't get, because here we didn't increment this a value. Okay, let's try what happened. I'll simply run this. You can see this infinity time executing this. Okay, this execution continuously happen. Okay, because here we didn't pass anything. Okay, let's terminate this execution. Now I want to increment this value. If I don't increment this value, then every time this while loop get a true and it's continuously executing. Okay, it's never stop. I'll simply add here a plus plus, that means a is incrementing every time, and let's save and run. Now you can see here we got simply 1 to 10 value. Okay, 1 to 10 value. Here we simply put condition a less than equal to 10. A should be less than, or it should be equal. It not should be greater than 10. Okay, this while loop execute 10 time, and 11th time it's got 11 value inside a 11 value, and this condition is not satisfied, that's why this while loop stop execution, this while loop stop executing and control come outside this while loop. Okay, now here we saw while loop, then we have a do while loop. Let's understand do while loop. Do while loop is a similar to while loop, with the only difference that it check for the condition after execution the statement. It's check condition, it's first execute statement, then check this condition. It executed at least once, because their execution first and then check condition. This first time this statement execute, then check condition. If condition is a true, then continuously executing, otherwise it's come outside this iteration, come control outside this iteration. If you don't know this condition value, then we can use a do while loop. Okay, let's perform a practical. I'll simply define here do while loop. I'll simply define here do. For writing do while loop, we have to use two keyword. We have to use do and while. Do and while. Okay, here we have to use this semicolon after this while. And I'll simply put here value a less than equal to 10. Okay, I have to create a new variable int b equal to 1, because this a is already made 10. Okay, let's pass here b, let's save and write here system.out.println do while loop and let's print here b value. And we saw if you don't provide this plus plus, if you don't provide this increment value, then it go in an infinity execution. I'll simply pass here b plus plus and let's save and run. You can see first our while loop execute 10 time, then our do while loop execute this 10 time. But here we saw if this condition is not satisfied even that time also, this execute one time. Okay, I'll simply make this b 11. This b value is greater than this value, this 10 value. That means this condition is not satisfied, but still this do condition, do statement execute at least once. Okay, let's save and run this. You can see here we got do while loop 11. Okay, if this condition is satisfied or not satisfied, this do statement execute at least once. Okay, one time at least execute this. Okay, here we saw difference between while loop first check condition then execute statement, do while loop first execute statement then check condition. Okay, that is the difference between these two, while and do while. Okay, then we have a for loop. Let's first understand what is the for loop. When we know exactly how many times you want to loop throughout the block of code, then we use a for loop. Use the for loop instead of while loop if we know exactly how many times we have to iterate value, how many times we have to iterate value, then use for loop instead of using while loop. Here we know how many times execute loop. For loop use mostly iterate value. Now you can see in this flowchart, here we simply start execution, then initialize that execution variable, then we write a condition. There we can write a condition for a true or false, for define true or false. Then we have a counter. Okay, then we declare a counter and then we execute that statement. If execution happen successfully, then that counter update, that counter increment. Okay, we will see in a practical. Okay, let's open Eclipse and I'll simply create here for loop. Okay, for int, this is a initialize variable. You can see here we simply declare variable and initialize variable. I'll simply declare here I equal to 1. I'll simply declare variable, then I store 1 inside this I. That means we initialize that variable. Okay, then we have to write a condition. Okay, I'll simply write here condition I should be less than equal to 10. Okay, that's the condition. Then we have a counter. Then we have to write here counter, I should be increment. Okay, let's write here system.out.println and I'll simply print for loop. I'll simply write here print for loop and simply provide here I value. Now let's understand in this for loop, first we provide a initialization value. Okay, first we declare a variable, then we initialize that variable. We simply initialize that variable and we store one value inside that variable. Then we write a condition. Okay, I should be less than or equal to 10. Then we simply write here it should be increment or it should be decrement. Okay, here we simply write it should be increment. Okay, let's save and run this statement, run this program. You can see here we got print for loop 1, 2, 3 up to 10. Here you can observe, here we know how much time it should be iterate. Here we simply define an increment or decrement. Okay, if we know how many time iteration should be execute, that time we simply use a for loop. Okay, then we have a for each loop, or we can say enhance for loop. It's introduced in a Java 5 when we only want to print value. Okay, we only want to print value, that time we can use a enhance for loop or we can say for each loop. For example, you can see here print array value. Okay, let's declare here one array. I'll simply declare int arr array equal to, I'll store inside array, I'll simply store a random value 3, 4, 5, 6, any random value. And I want to iterate, I want to print this all value line by line. For that, we can simply use for each loop. Okay, control space, and you can see here for each loop. Okay, simply write here SYSO system.out.println and here for each loop. Okay, let's save and add here I. You can see here we simply pass this variable name. Here we simply pass this array variable name. Then we store a one by one value inside this I and we simply print that. Okay, we simply print that each iteration, each time we store a new value inside this I and we simply print that value. Let's save and run this and let's check output. Okay, you can see here for each loop 4, 3, 5, 6, 7, this random value that we declare inside a array. Now here we saw, here we first saw while loop, then we saw do while loop, then we saw for loop, then we saw for each loop. Then we have a jump statement. In a jump statement, we have a break statement and we have a continue statement. Let's see one by one. In a break statement is a loop control statement that is used to terminate the loop. As soon as break statement is encountered from within a loop, the loop iteration stop there and control go to the first line after this loop. Now you can see in this diagram, here we simply define a one loop. Inside a loop, here we simply add one condition. If that condition is satisfied, then break this iteration and terminate this iteration. Okay, let's open Eclipse and I'll simply define a, here we saw already this for loop. Inside this for loop, we will simply use this break statement. Okay, I'll simply add here condition if I value equal to 7, I value is 8, then break this statement. Okay, then simply break this statement. Okay, let's save this and run this and let's check print for loop how many time printed. It should be print 10 time, but you can see here we print only till the 7 time, because you can see in a 8 iteration we simply break the statement and we simply terminate this for loop. Okay, this is a use of break statement, simply terminate the termination of execution this for loop for using a break statement. Then we have a continue statement. Continue statement used for a skip current iteration and jump next iteration. Continue used for a skip iteration. Here we simply define one condition. Condition is satisfied, then execute this continue. Continue is a execute, then skip remaining execution, skip remaining code and directly jump to the next iteration. Okay, I'll show here. Okay, let's write here one more condition. If I equal to 5, then continue this statement. Now what means this continue statement? If I value is the 5, then skip this remaining code inside this for loop and control go in a next iteration. Skip this current iteration and control go in a next iteration. Okay, let's save and run this and let's check what we got output. Okay, you can see here we got 1, 2, 3, 4 and here we did not get 5. Okay, directly 6, 7 and after 7 we directly apply here break statement. In a 5 here we simply skip, in a 8 here we simply break. Okay, skip means only skip the current iteration and break means terminate directly encounter this for loop, directly stop execution this for loop. Okay, there is a difference between for a continue only skip current iteration and break directly encounter, directly stop this for loop. Now here in this video we saw while loop, we saw do while loop, we saw for each loop and we saw use of continue and break statement. For this video, that's it. We will see next topic in a next video. Till that, bye bye.